Hi everybody, my name is Mukesh. Before I go into the details of this video, let me talk to you about Cisco CCNA certification and Networking Academy for just a minute. Most of you must have heard about CCNA or must have come across this term CCNA whenever you type in professional certifications through Google. CCNA is one of the most widely known and recognized certifications in the IT field. CCNA actually stands for Cisco Certified Network Associate. Any person who wants to pursue a career in networking or let it be security, be it from an engineering background or diploma background, can choose CCNA, study it and get certified provided they put in the required effort. In an attempt to make students industry ready and also to provide them enough networking skills to excel in their chosen career path, Cisco has set up academic alliances with colleges and universities under the name Cisco Networking Academy, also commonly referred to as Cisco NetAcad, where certified faculty members will teach different courses offered by Cisco NetAcad platform directly to the aspiring students. I am proud to have been associated with Cisco for the past 3 years. I am also a certified instructor for CCNA and CCNA CyberOps courses. So in this video, I would like to talk more about the courses that offer under CCNA certification and also the overview about CCNA 1 Introduction to Networks course. Cisco has recently released the latest version of CCNA, which is CCNA version 7. Few changes have been made to this version, and the most notable of the lot is the reduction in the number of courses that are considered to be a part of the certification. Earlier in CCNA version 6, we used to study 4 courses, but under CCNA 7, there are only 3 courses now. The courses being Introduction to Networks, which is also called as CCNA 1, and Switching, Routing, and Wireless Essentials, commonly referred to as SRWE, also called as CCNA 2, and Enterprise, Networking, Security, and Automation, ENSA, which is also called as CCNA 3. Also, the curriculum has been updated to reflect the new technological changes happening in the networking field. For CCNA 7, it's mandatory to install Packet Tracer version 6.3, where you can actually download it from the Networking Academy platform. Please make sure that you install Packet Tracer 6.3 before you opt to work on any Packet Tracer activities and also taking up of skills exams. Remember that also when you downloaded the Packet Tracer 6.3, it will ask you for a guest login where only the students belonging to Networking Academy or the persons who have a valid NetAcad login can only work with Packet Tracer for free. In this video, I am going to provide an overview about the first of the 3 courses, which is Introduction to Networks, commonly called as ITN. It is also most commonly called as CCNA 1. It provides all the fundamentals and basic building blocks in the networking domain. It also works like a prerequisite course for the remaining 2 CCNA courses because this is the only course where you can study basics of networking. Now, this course has been divided into 17 modules in total and 64 Check Your Understanding CYU quizzes, 6 module group exams, 2 skills exams, and 1 final exam. Here you can see in this particular slide, it gives you an overview about what the different learning components are. And all these components do have a Packet Tracer activities attached to them. And as I said earlier, you need to have Packet Tracer version 6.3 installed for this particular course to do all the activities and also to take up the skills exam. So let me talk to you about the different modules that are being covered under CCNA 1 and what each module does. Now, as we discussed earlier, this is what it actually gives you, all the fundamentals and basics. Please mention that some of the modules which are covered under CCNA 1 are not part of your assessment exams. This is because they are considered to be prerequisites or basics terminology. I will discuss more about them when I discuss about individual modules one by one. So And also, please make sure or please note that you do not require any prerequisites to study CCNA course, because it starts from the basics of networks and then it goes on with the complexity. Now, this is module one. So module one is called as Networking Today, where it covers most of the basics of networks, something which you can study, like common types of networks, how do you represent a network, what are the different topologies that are involved, what are the different network components that we use, what are the required properties of a reliable network, what are the current trends that are going on, and also some basics about network security. And last part in this particular module covers about the different career opportunities, what are the certifications that are being provided, etc. So this module gives you an overview of how network is today, what are the different trends that are happening, and what is the current state of the networks. And we move on to the module two. Here, this module actually talks about the switch and end device configuration. Here you get to use, to see the different representations of networking devices, which you commonly see in packet tracer. In this particular module, we start implementing how the packet tracer activities as to which or how a switch is being configured, or what are the different commands that you need to find out. And first of all, you get a glimpse of Cisco IOS. It is an operating system which is present in almost all the networking devices. So what is the command structure, how to configure, what are the basic steps of configuration of for any device, and how do you save these configurations, what are the ports and addresses, and also how do you configure an IP address. This module is the starting point where you start working with the switches and routers or even Cisco devices, and how do you interact with an IOS. And module three is, once again, it is very much in line to the theoretical part that you study as part of your computer networks course. So here we discuss about, the module itself is named as protocols and modules. Here we discuss about the rules, protocols, what are the different protocol suites that we use, what are standards organizations which overview or which oversee the entire internet, what are they, how they are divided, what are the different branches they have, and also most importantly, what are the different reference models that we have, what do you mean by data encapsulation, how do you access the data. All these things are covered in this particular module. Here we get a first-hand view of the TCP/IP reference model and the OSI reference model, how the protocols are working, and how these are actually placed within the reference model to as a layered architecture. In this, you get this all in this particular module. Moving on, the module 4 is also very much similar to what you study as part of your physical layer in the computer networks course. So module 4 is the physical layer. Here we understand why do we need a physical layer, first of all, and what are the different types of cables that a physical layer has to deal with, what are the different characteristics of a physical layer, and also we study in depth about the different cabling that we use every day. We study about the UTP cabling, copper cabling, STP cabling, fiber optic cabling. More information will be happening on what are the types of media and how they are classified, and what are the types of connectors that we need. All these things are covered in this particular module. It is a little bit more than what you usually cover as part of your theoretical course, but it actually gives you a very good insight to understand how to handle different media. And also you get a glimpse about the different types of wireless media that are commonly used. Now, module 5 actually tells you about the number systems. Earlier I was saying that there are some modules in this particular CCNA 1 on which the assessment will not be happening. This is one such module. And the reason why they include this module is because when working with IPv4 and IPv6 addresses, which are part of the CCNA 1, you need to understand about what the different number systems are, how to convert them, how to represent these things. So only we will be studying about two things, binary system, hexadecimal system. The reason is IPv4 is actually shown in decimal notations. IPv4 is shown in hexadecimal notations. So to understand these addresses, you need to have a very good understanding about the number systems. So that is the reason it is now added as a module in CCNA 7. Now for module 6, it covers about the data link layer. What is the purpose of data link layer? And what are the different sublayers of a data link layer? What happens in this? And what do you mean by framing? All those things will be covered under data link layer. What is the purpose of it? Why it is called as layer? What kind of objectives it is there? All these things are covered under module 6. In coming to the module 7, what we do here is we talk about Ethernet switching. That means how a switch handles the networks, or what is the role played by a switch in a network, how it actually builds its MAC table, and where does it get these MAC addresses. All those kind of things are covered under module 7, which we call it as Ethernet switching. Also here we study about Ethernet frame, which should be a part of your computer network syllabus. Once again, we define the fields, we understand what each field does, and what do you mean by a MAC address, how a MAC address is being prepared, and how it is actually unique in the entire network, and what are the different forwarding methods of a switch, which is very important. And moving on, we come to the next module, module 8, which is the network layer. Here, what we study is what are the different characteristics that make up your network layer. The usual protocol that we use in network layer is IP, Internet Protocol. And how does an IPv4 packet fare? Or what do you mean by about IPv6 packet? How a host routes, and what are the router routing tables, and what are the different fields that make up a routing table, and how does the network layer make a decision of forwarding a particular packet onto which outgoing interfaces? All these things are covered in this particular module. Moving on, then we come to the module 9, which is address resolution, or we study in depth about the ARP protocol, address resolution protocol, and also the new protocol called as ND, which is neighbor discovery in IPv6. So this is also once again a small module which gives you information about how ARP works, and also what is the role, and it also gives you a comparison of the roles played by the MAC address and the IP addresses. Module 10 once again covers the device configurations. As I said earlier, in module 2 you get an introduction into the Cisco IOS. It will tell you the different types of networking devices, what are the basic steps to do the configurations of a device. In the same lines, we study about the router. How do you do the basic configuration of a router? The most important thing which separates a router configuration is the identification of the interfaces, and how do you define the interfaces? How do you assign the addresses to the interfaces? Once again, it's very easy, as long as you know the basics right, you understand the command structure right. So the module 10 is going to tell you all the configuration commands that are required to do a router configuration. And also you will understand the configuring the default gateway for the networks, which plays a crucial role when you are connecting different networks. Next comes module 11, where you study about IPv4 addresses. So it gives you a complete overview of how the IPv4 addresses are divided, what are the different types of addresses that we use, what is the meaning of public and private IP addresses, and most importantly, it gives you the explanation, or gives you the overview of the subnetting, where most of the people feel worried about. Frankly speaking, subnetting is very easy, provided that you understand the need for it and the way and the procedure to do. This module actually gives you a very clear explanation of subnetting an IP address or IPv4 address area. So as you can see, there are different things that are covered here. What is the IPv4 address structure? What do you mean by the prefix notation? How do you apply the subnet mask? What are the different types? How do you segment a network into smaller subnets? And what are the subnets? Prefix 8, prefix 16, these things. How do you do the subnetting according to the requirements? And also, last but not the least, we will cover about something called as VLSM, variable length subnet masking. So here we define a flexible address scheme, not like we don't have a fixed prefix, where we can actually go for subnetting the networks according to the requirement based on the number of hosts per network. So how do you implement it? There are multiple packet tracer activities which will help you to understand these things, and there are multiple problems where once you start doing them, you will be able to understand better. So next thing comes to the same kind of subnetting schemes and everything we have to implement for IPv6 also. Your module 2 covers the IPv6 issues, including the type, what kind of addressing we use, what is the format of an IPv6 address, what are the different address types we use in IPv6, and the GUA LLS static configurations, link address, and global unicast address, dynamic addressing, how it is being configured, what are the IPv6 multicast addresses, and finally, how do you subnet an IPv6 address. Subnetting an IPv6 address is quite easy when you compare with IPv4, simply because in IPv6 we don't consider the wastage of IP addresses, because we have so many IP addresses we are least bothered about it. So subnetting an IPv6 address is much more easier than IPv4 addresses. So moving on from that point, we come to the module 13, which is once again a very small module, which will talk about the ICMP protocol, Internet Control Message Protocol, which is used for sending out messages, like any kind of issues with the network, what is happening, all the ping and trace route testing. I actually use ICMP. It consists of different tools to find out the status of a network. And this module is very small, and it might not be coming for your assessment. But the next module, which is your transport layer, which is module 14, and it closely resembles whatever you study as a theoretical part of your computer networks course. Here we study about the TCP protocol. We also study about the UDP protocol, the TCP header, UDP header. What do you mean by port numbers? How the communication happens? And also the different characteristics of the transport layer, what it does it provide? How does the reliability is implemented, and how flow control comes into play, and why we need to choose UDP communication where UDP is not reliable. All those kind of things are explained under transport layer. Module 15 covers your application layer, where we come across the different protocols that are commonly used in your application layer, such as your email, FTP, all those things. And for those things, we have to understand there are some protocols which we use regularly. Those kind of things we study under module 15. To just name a few, you will be learning about how DNS, domain name system, and dynamic host configuration protocol DHCP operate. So these things, and also file sharing services like FTP, TFTP, and these things are explained in module 15. You will be giving an overview of application layer, what it does and how does it support end user applications. That is covered under module 15. Then we come to the module 16, which provides you the basics of network security. So here we will be studying about what do you mean by a threat, what do you mean by a vulnerability, how do you understand that, and what are the different types of attacks, how do you classify the attacks, and how do you mitigate these attacks, and also you study about the device security. This actually plays a crucial role, because any networking administrator is also bothered, not just bothered about configuring a network, but is also bothered about securing a network, which plays a crucial role in modern day networks. So this module gives you the basics that you require to understand the security component of a network. And the last module is building up a small network, where whatever you learned in all the previous modules, you have to apply them here. So verify what are all the IOS commands, how do you verify the connectivity, what are the different troubleshooting methodologies, how are the different troubleshooting scenarios that we have, and identify the protocols and applications that we use for a small network. So module 17 is like a culmination of all the earlier modules, all the technology and the knowledge skills that whatever you studied there, how do you implement them? So these are all the 17 modules of CCNA1 Introduction to Networks course. This is not the toughest module. This is a very simple module, and it is very much in line with whatever theoretical concepts that you study under computer networks course as part of your curriculum. And to go with this, to pass this module, you have to take 6 module exams and also 2 skills exams. And finally, there will be 1 final exam. And to get guys used to this, how the questions are asked, you will have the 64, as I mentioned in the earlier slides, you have 64 CYU quizzes and also 1 module quiz at the end of each module. So what I request everybody is, once you study these modules, first do these quizzes first. So to get yourself used to the kind of questions, and you can actually test yourself. Then we can move on to the modules exams. So this will be my objective for making this video, is to give you an overview about all the different modules that take up your CCNA1, and you should be able to understand what are the expected outcomes from this course. So if you have any other issues, you can ping me, or you can actually put your comments into the section below, whatever you want more. And I will be doing modules individually, one by one, from here onwards. So guys, thank you very much, and be safe. Thank you. Goodbye.